Hi, I'm Pure Excellence, the most important political mind this side of the United States.
And if you've been listening to this channel for any length of time, you know we don't take sides. We just provide an environment for all us to come together and let's just talk on solutions. As we look in the comments, it's a 50-50. Some people come here to vent for Trump. Some come to vent against Trump. Now, we are not partisan. People should be able to come and hear a biased view of a topic. You never really know a person until you study them. If you think you know Donald J. Trump, his family, his life, I got news for you. On behalf of the Stimulus Check Lighthouse community, me, the team, and narrator James, we present to you the mini biography of Donald J. Trump. James, take it away.
1. The Stimulus Lighthouse Alert Community presents the mini biography of Donald J. Trump. Starting. Billionaire property magnate and previous Truth television character Donald Trump is the 45th President of the United States. Who is Donald Trump? Donald Trump is the 45th and present President of the United States. He took office on January 20, 2017. Previously, he was a property magnate and a former reality TV star. In 1980, he opened the Grand Hyatt New York, which made him the city's best-known designer. In 2004, Trump began starring in the hit NBC Truth series The Apprentice. Trump turned his attention to politics, and in 2015 he announced his candidacy for President of the United States on the Republican ticket. Trump ended up being the official Republican prospect for president on July 19, 2016, and upset Democratic prospect Hillary Clinton on November 8, 2016, to end up being the 45th President of the United States. 4 years later, Trump lost his bid for re-election to previous Vice President Joe Biden. Early life and education. Donald John Trump was born on June 14, 1946, in Queens, New York. He was an energetic, assertive child. In the 1950s, the Trump's wealth increased with the post-war real estate boom. Trump was raised Presbyterian by his mother, and he determines as a mainline Protestant. At age 13, Trump's parents sent him to the New York Military Academy, hoping the discipline of the school would transport his energy in a positive manner. He did well at the academy, both socially and academically, rising to become a star athlete and student leader by the time he finished in 1964. Trump went into Fordham University in 1964. He transferred to the Wharton School of Finance at the University of Pennsylvania 2 years later on and finished in 1968 with a degree in economics. Throughout his years at college, Trump operated at his daddy's property organization during the summer season. He also secured education deferments for the draft for the Vietnam War and ultimately a 1Y medical deferment after he graduated. Moms and dads and siblings. Daddy, Trump's father, Frederick Trump, was a contractor and real estate designer who focused on building and operating middle-income homes in Queens, Staten Island, and Brooklyn. Mom, Trump's mother, Mary McLeod, immigrated from Tong, Scotland, in 1929 at the age of 17. She and Fred Trump wed in 1936. The couple settled in Jamaica, Queens, a community that was, at the time, filled with Western European immigrants. As the family's wealth increased, Mary became a New York socialite and philanthropist. Fred died in 1999, and Mary died the following year. Brother or sisters, Trump is the fourth of five children. Mary Ann Trump Berry was a senior judge of the U.S. Court of Appeals for the Third Circuit, however took an inactive statistics not long after her sibling became president. Fred Trump Jr. worked briefly with his father and after that became a pilot. He battled with alcohol and passed away in 1981 at the age of 43, prompting Donald to reveal that he never drinks alcohol or take drugs. He had a profound effect on my life, due to the fact that you never understand where you're going to wind up, Trump stated. Elizabeth Trump Grau is a retired banker who is wed to movie producer James Grau. Robert Trump was Donald's younger bro who invested much of his career working for the household business. He died in 2020, age 71. Donald Trump and father Fred Trump at opening of Wallman Rink in 1987. Donald Trump and dad, Fred Trump, at the opening of Wallman Rink in 1987. Wives, Melania Trump. Trump is presently wed to former Slovenian designer Melania Trump, Knauss, who is more than 23 years his junior. In January 2005, the couple married in a highly publicized and lavish wedding event. Among the many celebrity guests at the wedding event were Hillary Clinton and previous President Bill Clinton. Ivana Trump. In 1977, Trump married his first better half Ivana Trump, Ne Zelnichkova Winkelmayer, a New York-style design who had actually been an alternate on the 1972 Czech Olympic ski team. She was named vice president and in charge of design in the Trump organization and played a significant function in supervising the renovation of the Commodore and the Plaza Hotel. The couple had three kids together, Donald Trump Jr., Ivanka, and Eric. They went through a highly advertised divorce that was finalized in 1992. Marla Maples. In 1993, Trump wed his second better half, Marla Maples, an actress with whom he had actually been included for some time and already had a daughter, Tiffany. Trump would ultimately apply for an extremely advertised divorce from Maples in 1997, which became last in June 1999. A prenuptial arrangement allotted $2 million to Maples. Children. Trump has five kids. He and his first other half, Ivana Trump, had three children together, Donald Trump Jr., born in 1977, Ivanka Trump, born in 1981, and Eric Trump, born in 1984. Trump and his second spouse, Marla Maples, had child Tiffany Trump in 1993. An existing spouse Melania Trump brought to life Trump's youngest child, Barron William Trump, in March 2006. Trump's sons Donald Jr. and Eric work as executive vice presidents for the Trump Organization. They took over the family company while their daddy acts as president. Trump's daughter Ivanka was also an executive vice president of the Trump Organization. She left the business and her own style label to join her father's administration and end up being an unsettled assistant to the president. Her husband, Jared Kushner, is likewise a senior consultant to President Trump. Trump's real estate and businesses. Trump followed his father into a career in real estate development, bringing his grander aspirations to the family company. Trump's business endeavors include the Trump Organization, Trump Tower, gambling establishments in Atlantic City, and TV franchises like The Apprentice and Miss Universe. Trump has business offers with the Javits Center and the Grand Hyatt New York, as well as other property ventures in New York City, Florida, and Los Angeles. Federal earnings disclosure forms Trump submitted in 2017 list Trump's golf courses, consisting of Trump National Doral and Mar-a-Lago in Florida, as making about half of his income. Other monetary endeavors include aircraft, merchandise, and royalties from his two books, The Art of the Deal and Crippled America, How to Make America Great Again. The Art of the Deal. In 1987, Trump published the book The Art of the Deal, co-authored with Tony Schwartz. In the book, Trump describes how he effectively makes organization deals. I don't do it for the money. I've got enough, far more than I'll ever require. I do it to do it. Deals are my art kind, Trump composed. The book made the New York Times bestseller list, although the variety of copies offered has been debated. Sales have actually been approximated at in between 1 to 4 million copies to date. Schwartz later on ended up being an outspoken critic of the book and of Trump, stating he felt sorry for assisting make the president more attractive than he is. Wealth. For many years, Trump's net worth have been a subject of public debate. Because Trump has actually not openly released his tax returns, it's not possible to definitively determine his wealth in the previous or today. However, Trump valued his business as a minimum of $1.37 billion on his 2017 federal monetary disclosure kind, published by the Office of Government Ethics. Trump's 2018 disclosure type put his revenue for the year at a minimum of $434 million from all sources. In 1990, Trump asserted his own net worth in the neighborhood of $1.5 billion. At the time, the property market was in decrease, reducing the value of an income from Trump's empire. The Trump Organization needed an enormous infusion of loans to keep it from collapsing, a scenario that raised questions as to whether the corporation could make it through bankruptcy. Some observers saw Trump's decline as symbolic of many of the business, economic, and social excesses that had actually arisen in the 1980s. A May 2019 investigation by the New York Times of 10 years of Trump's tax information found that between 1985 and 1994, his businesses lost money every year. The paper computed that Trump's companies suffered $1.17 billion in losses over the years. Trump later on safeguarded himself on Twitter, calling the Times report a highly unreliable fake news hit task. He tweeted that he reported losses for tax functions, which doing so was a sport amongst property designers. Tax returns. Trump's net worth was questioned over the course of his 2016 presidential run, and he courted controversy after repeatedly refusing to release his tax returns while they were being audited by the Internal Revenue Service. He did not release his tax returns during the election, and he has not to date. It was the first time a significant celebration prospect had not released such details to the public prior to a presidential election since Richard Nixon in 1972. After Democrats gained back control of your house with the 2018 elections, Trump once again dealt with calls to release his tax returns. In April 2019, Congressman Richard Neal, chairman of the House Ways and Means Committee, requested 6 years' worth of the president's personal and company tax returns from the IRS. Treasury Secretary Steve Mnuchin turned down the demand, in addition to Neal's follow-up subpoena for the files. In May, the New York State Assembly passed legislation that authorized tax authorities to release the president's state go back to the chairman of your House Ways and Means Committee, the Senate Finance Committee, and the Joint Committee on Taxation for any defined and legitimate legislative purpose. With New York City working as the home for the Trump Organization, it was thought that the state returns would include much of the same information as the president's federal returns. In September 2019, Manhattan District Attorney Cyrus Vance Jr. subpoenaed the accounting firm Mazars USA for Trump's personal and corporate tax returns dating back to 2011, triggering a difficulty from the president's lawyers. A Manhattan federal district judge dismissed Trump's claim in October, though the U.S. Circuit Court of Appeals for the Second Circuit accepted briefly postpone enforcement of the subpoena while thinking about arguments in the case. A couple of days later on, that very same appeals court declined Trump's bid to obstruct another subpoena provided to Mazars USA, this one from your House Committee on Oversight and Reform. After the U.S. Supreme Court consented to hear arguments over whether the president might obstruct the disclosure of his monetary information to congressional committees and the Manhattan district lawyer in December 2019, the cases existed to the court the following May. Suits and investigations, Fair Housing Act discrimination trial. In 1973, the federal government filed a complaint against Trump, his dad and their company, declaring that they had discriminated against occupants and possible tenants based on their race, a violation of the Fair Housing Act, which becomes part of the Civil Rights Act of 1968. 2. After a lengthy legal battle, the case was settled in 1975. As part of the arrangement, the Trump company had to train workers about the Fair Housing Act and notify the community about its fair real estate practices. Trump wrote about the resolution of the case in his 1987 memoir Art of the Deal. In the end, the government couldn't show its case, and we wound up taking a minor settlement without admitting any guilt. Trump University. In 2005, Trump launched his for-profit Trump University, using classes in real estate and acquiring and handling wealth. The endeavor had actually been under analysis practically since its inception, and at the time of his 2015 governmental bid, it stayed the topic of numerous suits. In the events, complainants implicated Trump of scams, incorrect advertising, and breach of contract. Debate about the fits made headings when Trump suggested that U.S. District Court Judge Gonzalo Curiel could not be impartial in supervising two class action cases since of his Mexican heritage. On November 18, 2016, Trump, who had previously vowed to take the matter to trial, settled three of the suits for $25 million without admission of liability. In a statement from New York Attorney General Eric Schneiderman, he called the settlement a spectacular turnaround by Trump and a significant success for the over 6,000 victims of his deceitful university. Donald J. Trump Foundation. Later, in a separate occurrence connected to Trump University, it was reported that Florida Attorney General Pam Bondi chose not to join the existing New York fraud lawsuit. This came simply days after she had gotten a substantial project donation from the Donald J. Trump Foundation, which was established in 1988 as a personal charity organization created to make donations to nonprofit groups. In November 2016, it was reported that Bondi's name was on Trump's list as a possible U.S. Attorney General contender. As a result of the improper contribution to Bondi's project, Trump was required to pay the IRS a penalty and his foundation came under scrutiny about making use of its funds for non-charitable activities. According to tax records, the Trump Foundation itself was found to have received no charitable gifts from Trump since 2008, which all donations since that time had originated from outside contributors. In fall 2019, after Trump confessed to misusing money raised by his structure to promote his governmental campaign and settle financial obligations, he was ordered to pay $2 million in damages, and the foundation was forced to shutter its doors. Political party. Trump is presently signed up as a Republican. He has actually switched parties a number of times in the past three decades. In 1987, Trump signed up as a Republican. 2 years later, in 1989, he registered as an independent. In 2000, Trump ran for president for the very first time on the Reform platform. In 2001, he signed up as a Democrat. By 2009, Trump had actually changed back to the Republican celebration, although he signed up as an independent in 2011 to permit a prospective run in the following year's governmental election. He lastly went back to the Republican Party to endorse Mitt Romney's 2012 presidential run and has stayed a Republican considering that. Donald Trump-Hillary Clinton debate photo. Hillary Clinton speaks as Republican presidential nominee Donald Trump listens during the presidential debate at Hofstra University on September 26, 2016, in Hempstead, New York. 2016 presidential campaign versus Clinton. Trump became the main Republican candidate for president in the 2016 presidential election against Democrat Clinton. Defying surveys and media forecasts, he won the majority of Electoral College votes in a sensational victory on November 8, 2016. In spite of losing the popular vote to Hillary Clinton by nearly 2.9 million votes, Trump's electoral win 306 Electoral College votes to Clinton's 232 clinched his success as the 45th president of the United States. After one of the most contentious presidential races in U.S. history, Trump's increase to the office of president was considered a definite rejection of establishment politics by blue-collar and working-class Americans. In his success speech, Trump said, "I pledge to every resident of our land that I will be president for all Americans." About his advocates, he said, "As I've stated from the beginning, ours was not a campaign, but rather an incredible and excellent movement made up of millions of hardworking men and women who love their nation and desire a much better, brighter future on their own and for their households." Election platforms. On July 21, 2016, Trump accepted the governmental election at the Republican National Convention in Cleveland. In his speech, he laid out the problems he would deal with as president, consisting of violence in America, the economy, immigration, trade, terrorism, and the visit of Supreme Court justices. On migration, he said, "We are going to construct a fantastic border wall to stop unlawful immigration, to stop the gangs and the violence, and to stop the drugs from putting into our communities." He also assured advocates that he would renegotiate trade offers, decrease taxes and government guidelines, rescind the Affordable Care Act, otherwise referred to as Obamacare, protect Second Amendment weapon rights, and rebuild our depleted military, asking the countries the U.S. is protecting to pay their reasonable share. Inauguration. On January 20, 2017, Trump was sworn in as the 45th President of the United States by Chief Justice of the United States John Roberts. Trump took the oath of workplace, placing his hand on the Bible that was utilized at Abraham Lincoln's inauguration, and his own household Bible, which was presented to him by his mother in 1955 when he graduated from Sunday school at his household's Presbyterian church. In his inaugural speech on January 20, Trump sent out a populist message that he would put the American individuals above politics. "What really matters is not which party manages our government, but whether our government is controlled by the people," he stated. January 20, 2017, will be kept in mind as the day the people ended up being the rulers of this country again. He went on to paint a bleak photo of an America that had failed many of its residents, explaining families caught in hardship, an ineffective education system, and criminal activity, drugs and gangs. "This American carnage stops right here and stops right now," he stated. The day after Trump's inauguration, millions of protesters demonstrated throughout the United States and worldwide. The Women's March on Washington drew over 500,000 people to protest Trump's position on a variety of issues ranging from immigration to environmental protection. Donald Trump dances with other half Melania Trump at the Liberty Inaugural Ball on January 20, 2017 in Washington, D.C. Donald Trump dances with better half Melania Trump at the Liberty Inaugural Ball on January 20, 2017, in Washington, D.C. First 100 days. The first 100 days of Trump's presidency lasted from January 20, 2017, up until April 29, 2017. In the very first days of his presidency, Trump issued a number of back-to-back executive orders to make good on a few of his campaign promises, as well as several orders focused on rolling back policies and regulations that were taken into place throughout the Obama administration. Numerous of Trump's crucial policies that got rolling during Trump's first 100 days in workplace included his first Supreme Court election, steps towards constructing a wall on the Mexico border, a travel ban for a number of predominantly Muslim nations, the very first moves to dismantle the Affordable Care Act, and the U.S. withdrawal from the Paris Climate Agreement. In addition, Trump signed orders to execute a federal hiring freeze, withdraw from the Trans-Pacific Partnership, and restore the Mexico City policy that bans federal financing of non-governmental companies abroad that promote or perform abortions. He signed an order to scale back financial regulation under the Dodd-Frank Act, developed by the Obama administration and passed by Congress after the financial crisis of 2008. And he required a lifetime foreign lobbying ban for members of his administration, and a five-year restriction for all other lobbyings. On March 16, 2017, the president launched his suggested budget plan. The budget plan described his prepare for increased spending for the military, veterans affairs and national security, including developing a wall on the border with Mexico. It likewise made extreme cuts to many government firms, including the Environmental Protection Agency and the State Department, along with the elimination of the National Endowment for the Arts, the National Endowment for the Humanities, moneying for the Corporation for Public Broadcasting, and the Community Development Block Grant Program, which supports Meals on Wheels. These cuts showed controversial, nevertheless, and much of this financing was restored. Trump's Supreme Court nominations. Trump has actually chosen three Supreme Court justices: Neil Gorsuch, Brett Kavanaugh, and Amy Coney Barrett. Neil Gorsuch. On January 31, 2017, Trump nominated Judge Gorsuch to the Supreme Court. The 49-year-old conservative judge was appointed by President George W. Bush to the United States Court of Appeals for the 10th Circuit in Denver. Judge Gorsuch was educated at Columbia, Harvard, and Oxford, and clerked for Justices Byron White and Anthony Kennedy. The election came after Merrick Garland, President Obama's nominee to replace the late Antonin Scalia, was rejected a confirmation hearing by Senate Republicans. As Gorsuch's legal viewpoint was considered to be similar to Scalia's, the choice drew strong appreciation from the conservative side of the aisle. "Millions of voters stated this was the single essential issue for them when they elected me for president," Trump said. "I am a guy of my word. Today I am keeping another guarantee to the American people by nominating Neil Gorsuch to the Supreme Court." After Gorsuch provided 3 days of testimony before the Senate Judiciary Committee in March, the Senate convened on April 6 to advance his election. Democrats mainly held company to reject the 60 votes needed to proceed, leading to the very first effective partisan filibuster of a Supreme Court nominee. However, Republicans rapidly countered with another historic move, conjuring up the nuclear alternative to lower the threshold for advancing Supreme Court nominations from 60 votes to a simple bulk of 50. On April 7, Gorsuch was validated by the Senate to end up being the 113th Justice of the Supreme Court, Brett Kavanaugh. On July 9, 2018, Trump nominated Kavanaugh following the retirement of Justice Kennedy. A textualist and originalist in the mold of Scalia, the nomination continued the rightward push of the Supreme Court. Democrats pledged to fight the nomination, and Kavanaugh was nearly derailed by allegations of sexual assault. He made confirmation in a close vote that October. Amy Coney Barrett. Following the death of liberal favorite Ruth Bader Ginsburg, Trump chose conservative Judge Barrett, from the U.S. Court of Appeals for the Seventh Circuit, on September 26, 2020. Environment change. Throughout the 2016 presidential election, Trump called environment change a scam. He later recanted, stating, "I don't think it's a hoax, I believe there's most likely a difference." However, in an October 2018 interview on Fox News, Trump implicated climate scientists of having a political agenda and said that he was skeptical that humans were responsible for rising temperatures. In November 2018, the Fourth National Climate Assessment, assembled by 13 federal companies consisting of the EPA and Department of Energy, discovered that, left unchecked, environment change would be catastrophic for the U.S. economy. Trump told reporters, "I don't believe it." In June 2019, Trump consulted with Prince Charles and supposedly discussed climate change at length. In an interview with British television host Piers Morgan, Trump stated, "I believe that there is a modification in weather and I believe it changes both ways. It used to be called global warming, that wasn't working, then it was called climate modification, and now really it is called extreme weather." 3. Trump later on told ITV's Good Morning Britain that he pushed back Prince Charles' tips that the United States do more to fight climate change, saying that the US now has among the cleanest environments there are based on all statistics. Paris Climate Agreement. On June 1, 2017, Trump withdrew from the 2015 Paris Climate Agreement, which President Obama had actually signed up with along with the leaders of 195 other nations. The accord requires all getting involved nations to lower greenhouse gas emissions in an effort to curb climate modification over the taking place century, and likewise to assign resources for the research and development of alternative energy sources. With Trump's decision, the United States joined Syria and Nicaragua as the only three countries to turn down the accord. Nevertheless, Nicaragua eventually signed up with the Paris Climate Agreement months later. Oil extraction. Soon after taking workplace, Trump revived the controversial Keystone XL and Dakota Access pipelines to transfer oil extracted in Canada and North Dakota. The pipelines had actually been halted by President Obama following demonstrations from ecological and Native American groups. Trump owned shares of Energy Transfer Partners, the company in charge of building and construction of the Dakota Access Pipeline, but sold his stake in the business in December 2016. Energy Transfer Partners CEO Kelsey Warren likewise added to Trump's presidential project, raising concerns over dispute of interest. Coal mining. On March 28, 2017, the president, surrounded by American coal miners, signed the Energy Independence Executive Order, requiring the Environmental Protection Agency to roll back Obama's Clean Power Plan, curb environment and carbon emissions regulations, and to rescind a moratorium on coal mining on U.S. federal lands. Endangered Species Act. In August 2019, the Trump administration announced it was revamping the Endangered Species Act. This consisted of modifications to legislation that gave the government increased discretion over matters of environment change and economic expense when determining whether a species ought to be secured. Donald Trump, President Donald Trump dealing with a crowd. Healthcare, among Trump's first executive orders in workplace was calling on federal companies to waive, defer, approve exemptions from, or hold up elements of the Affordable Care Act to lessen monetary burden on states, insurers and people. On March 7, 2017, House Republicans, led by Speaker Paul Ryan, presented the American Health Care Act, a strategy to repeal and replace the Affordable Care Act, ACA. However, the controversial expense ultimately didn't have sufficient Republican votes and was withdrawn a few weeks later, representing a major legal problem for Speaker Ryan and Trump. After extreme negotiations among celebration factions, a brand new Republican health care strategy was brought to a vote in the House of Representatives on May 4, 2017, and passed by a slim margin of 217 to 213. That passed the dollar to the Senate. Practically immediately after a draft was unveiled on June 22, conservative senators such as Ted Cruz declared they might not support the expense's failure to significantly lower premiums, while moderates like Susan Collins voiced issues over its steep cuts to Medicaid. On June 27, Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell chose to delay his plan to leck the bill. When the third, so-called slim repeal, costs lastly went to a vote on in the Senate July 28, it stopped working by three votes. In September, a new cost to rescind the Affordable Care Act was put forth by Senator Lindsey Graham of South Carolina and Senator Bill Cassidy of Louisiana. Nevertheless, on September 26, Senate Republicans revealed they would stagnate forward with the present strategy, as they lack the required votes. "We are disappointed in particular so-called Republicans," Trump reacted. On October 12, 2017, Trump signed an executive order in a move that might take apart the ACA without Congress's approval, expanding health insurance items mainly less thorough strategies through associations of little companies and more short-term medical protection. He also announced that he would eliminate health insurance aids, referred to as cost-sharing reduction payments, which lower the expense of deductibles for low-income Americans. They were expected to cost $9 billion in 2018 and $100 billion over the next years. Birth control mandate. On October 6, 2017, the Trump administration revealed a rollback of the contraception mandate put in place by the Obama administration's Affordable Care Act, which required insurers to cover birth control at no charge without copayments as a preventive service. For several years, the requirement was threatened by suits from conservative and religious groups. The Trump administration stated the new exemption applied to any company that challenged covering birth control services on the basis of truly held religious beliefs or ethical convictions. The change remains in line with Trump's pledges as a candidate to ensure that spiritual groups are not bullied by the federal government due to the fact that of their faiths. Challengers of the measure said that it could potentially impact hundreds of countless ladies which access to budget-friendly contraception in the mandate provided avoids unintended pregnancies and saves ladies' lives. Abortion. As president, Trump has said that he is strongly pro-life and wishes to ban all abortions except in cases of rape, incest, or when a lady's life remains in threat. He has actually supported bans on abortions after 20 weeks of pregnancy and has cited his visits of conservative Supreme Court judges Gorsuch and Kavanaugh as helping to make abortion laws in some states more limiting. Trump altered his beliefs on abortion from pro-choice to anti-abortion in 1999. In 2016, he stated that he supported some type of punishment for women who go through abortions. He later on launched a declaration saying he only believed professionals must be punished for performing abortions, not ladies for having them. In January 2020, after his administration threatened to cut federal funds to California over a required that the state's health insurance plans cover abortion, Trump ended up being the first sitting president to resolve the annual March for Life rally in Washington, D.C. Tax plan. On April 26, 2017, Trump revealed his tax plan in a one-page outline that would dramatically alter tax codes. The plan called for simplifying seven earnings tax brackets to 3, 10, 25, and 35%. The initial summary did not specify which earnings ranges would fall under those brackets. The strategy also proposed to reduce the corporate tax rate from 35 to 15%, remove the alternative minimum tax and estate tax, and streamline the process for submitting tax returns. The proposal did not resolve how the tax cuts may lower federal revenue and increase debt. On December 2, 2017, Trump attained the very first significant legislative success of his administration when the Senate passed a sweeping tax reform bill. Approved along celebration lines by a 51-49 vote, the cost drew criticism for extensive last-minute rewrites, with disappointed Democrats posting images of pages filled with crossed-out text and handwriting crammed into the margins. Among other measures, the Senate expense called for the slashing of the corporate tax rate from 35% to 20%, doubling individual reductions and ending the Obamacare required. It also consisted of a questionable arrangement that permitted unborn children to be named as beneficiaries of college savings accounts, which critics called an effort to support the pro-life movement. Despite quotes by the Congressional Budget Office that the costs would cost $1.5 trillion over a year, GOP senators insisted that charges would be offset by a growing economy. After the bill's passage, Trump tweeted, "Biggest tax bill and tax cuts in history simply passed in the Senate. Now, these great Republicans will be opting for last passage. Thank you to House and Senate Republicans for your hard work and commitment." On December 20th, the last tax bill officially passed both chambers of Congress. Following partisan battles over a cost bill in early 2018, which resulted in a short government shutdown and substitute procedures, Trump threatened to torpedo a $1.3 trillion spending cost with a last-minute veto. Reportedly mad that the cost did not fully fund his long-promised Mexican border wall, he nevertheless signed the bill into law on March 23rd, hours prior to another government shutdown would have entered into result. Transgender rights. On February 22, 2017, the Trump administration rolled back federal protection for transgender students to utilize bathrooms that represent their gender identity, enabling states and school districts to translate federal anti-discrimination law. On March 27, 2017, Trump signed numerous measures under the Congressional Review Act to reverse regulations associated with education, land use, and a blacklisting rule requiring federal specialists to divulge offenses of federal labor, wage, and work environment security laws. Later on that year, the president tweeted that he would enact a restriction on transgender individuals from serving in the military. The main policy entered into effect the following March with the statement that transgender persons with a history or medical diagnosis of gender dysphoria, individuals who the policy state may require considerable medical treatment, including medications and surgery, are disqualified from military service except under specific limited circumstances. Following a legal difficulty, the Supreme Court allowed the restriction to enter into result in January 2019, while permitting lower courts to hear additional arguments.